Coming up on Sports Weekly, the Cajon baseball team went on the road and picked up a big win against Riverside Poly. We'll hear from Cowboys head coach Robert Grande, plus highlights of Redlands going up against Grand Terrace at the Redlands Invitational softball tournament. That's coming up on Sports Weekly. Welcome back to Sports Weekly. The Cajon baseball team is looking to build some confidence and momentum before opening Citrus Belt League play at the end of March. The CBL will once again be ultra competitive, with the Cowboys hoping to challenge for a playoff spot and the league crown. The Cowboys will be battle tested for the CBL. Cajon taking on some great teams in tournament play, including Riverside Poly as part of the Rancho Cucamonga tournament. Cajon is hoping the great competition will pay off when CBL play rolls around. Brody Evans on the hill for Cajon against the Poly Bears, and he was the big story in this game. Evans ringing up some Riverside Poly batters while working his way through that Bears lineup. Poly would put some runners on base later in the game, but the big punch out coming up by Evans will end the threat right there. Behind a gem from Brody Evans, Cajon blanks Riverside Poly 9-0 the final score. Evans goes six innings, allowing just three hits with six strikeouts. No runs, of course. A great outing from Evans as the Cowboys continue to improve game by game.
What I've really liked about our team is our ability to battle late in games. At the same time, it's our ability to lose games late. So we're trying to find ourselves. Early on in the year, I had three of my four starting pitchers were injured. So this is, in essence, their spring training. So we're really trying to get them some work, some innings, and get prepared for, obviously, the CBL. We're going to find out about our character. You know, we know we're physical. We know we're big. We know we're strong. But obviously, our character when it comes to speed of game and being able to keep up with some of these really good programs out there. And we're excited. We're excited about the opportunity to play some really good competition.
If you had to pick an area of where this team might be strong going forward in the league play, on the mound, at the plate, defensively, I mean, where do you think this team might be strong?
We're probably a little bit ahead offensively than we were last year at this time. Pitching, we're definitely behind a little bit. Defensively, we're a little bit more mediocre. So we've got some improvements to do, but we have a little bit of time. We're going to play this tournament. We have a couple weeks to really get our pitching back in line. And I think once the pitching comes in line and we can throw strikes and get outs, we're going to be okay.
Now to the softball diamond, where some of the best high school teams in the Inland Empire were on display at the Redlands Invitational. Riverside Poly won the tournament championship, but the marquee matchup of the entire tournament was Redlands going up against Grand Terrace. The Titans won the CIF Southern Section Division III championship last year and currently one of the top-ranked teams in Division I right now. The Titans jumped on the Terriers early. That was Alicia Flores flaring the base hit to score Aaliyah Flores. Then it's Morgan Parsons driving home two more runs as Grand Terrace posted four runs in the first inning to grab a quick lead. But Redlands would rally in a big way. Bottom of the first, and Jada Overby connects on a two-run homer. The big blast gets the Terriers on the board, but trailing by a score of 4-2. Redlands would go back to the long ball when in the third inning, Jamie Stewart crushes a three-run homer. The Terriers broke out the big bats and picked up an impressive win against Grand Terrace. 6-5 the final score. Big win for Redlands at the tournament. Well, as for Grand Terrace, they're still the favorite to win the Sunkist League title this year and will be looking for back-to-back CIF championships. The Division III title last year was Grand, but Grand Terrace will be taking aim on the Division I title this season.
In this tournament right here, we'll figure things out, see what we have, new girls from last year, see where they're at, especially some of the new girls we brought on to see what they can do for us this year. And then, it's a progress for us, you know. I know it's a length of time. My goal, my focus is just be ready for playoffs. I think we're all happy. I know I'm excited. I'm excited to be in Division I. I thought we always played well in the past against Division I teams, so I'm not, too worried about that. I know it's going to be a lot tougher, but I think that's what keeps our team going, the challenge of actually being in Division I now and, just competing at the highest level that's possible. Now we'll see where we're really at, too. And that's what I talked about with the girls, and I look at it as my personal self, too. I'm always telling them to be the best that they can. So for me, you know, everyone's like, oh, you know, you're Division One now, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, well, you know, for me, I love that challenge. It shows me that I'm still ready to compete as a coach, and I'm still looking forward to the challenge of competing at that level, trying to get better every day. And, you know, for us, man, I'm just really happy. I'm excited to see where we fit in at Division One.
Still to come on Sports Weekly, the Indian Springs boys soccer team is racking up those all-star honors. Plus, Southern California Sports Club is set to kick off its second season. That's coming up on Sports Weekly on IEMG. That'll do it for this episode of Sports Weekly on IEMG. Be sure to check out the IE Media Group YouTube channel to watch this segment and all the past shows of Sports Weekly. And be sure you also hit the subscribe button so you'll never miss a moment of the action. I'm Pep Fernandez. I'll see you next time on Sports Weekly on IEMG.